I don't know what you had in mind, but here we stand on opposing sides. Let's go to war. Let's go to war!
Well, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Chaos! And we're kicking it off with probably the worst thing to kick it off with. ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. We're on the road to Blood Moon and the Royal Rumble. And, it doesn't look to get any better from here because look who arrives on Chaos. June Crable, Brenda Crable, Nancy Crable. The Crable sisters are here.
4-1-4, making her way to the ring from Charlottesville, Virginia, Nancy.
Well, Nancy Crable will be in a one-on-one match tonight on Chaos. Now, Nancy Crable has her hands a little bit full as she goes against Ayla tonight. Ayla's first match since returning at SummerSlam. And while, you know, it is good to see her back to some extent, it also has to be pretty bittersweet because, I mean, we're excited to see Ayla back, or at least we were excited. And, of course, I am interested to see where everything goes, but then again, the way that Ayla did it was just the bad part. It was the not-so-good part of Ayla returning, where she betrayed Nyla, and that wasn't very cool. That was pretty, you know, I wasn't a big fan of that. But Ayla McGardman looks to win the Heritage Championship, and she explained it all in her promo last week. If you have not seen Ayla's promo, I highly, highly, highly recommend you go back and take a look at it because it explains everything. And it gives Ayla a motive. Is it a bad motive? Yeah, it's a bad motive, but I mean, it's similar to Alpha. I guess understandable to an extent, but it doesn't make it tolerable. And it's funny how many similarities Ayla all of a sudden has to Alpha
and
nowadays.
Manitoba, Canada.
Both of them have similar reasoning for doing what they did. Gracie Lewis, 13XC Alpha, who betrayed Danielle Garcia for very similar reasons as to Ayla betraying Nyla. And I think that's a pretty interesting parallel given that all the problems A-List been going through have been because of Great D'Lo. Ayla's last match since returning for her match here tonight was against, ironically, 13XC Alpha at WrestleMania. So you can see how it all ties together. Ayla returns tonight to take on Nancy Crable in her first match back. On the road to the Royal Rumble, she looks to challenge Nyla for the Heritage Championship. But I feel like it's almost guaranteed that she will, given the circumstances of what happened at SummerSlam and what may happen in the future. Oh! And Nancy Crable starts it off badly by taunting in the face of Ayla. Ayla having absolutely none of it, and she is after the target. That is Nancy Crable. Ayla, who wants to become the Heritage Champion, show Nyla that she indeed was the best member coming out of the 17th event. Nyla was never the special one. She was never the gifted one. She was never the chosen one. Apparently, Ayla wants to prove it with all a lie and that people should have chosen her instead of Nyla. And there is truth to that. Nyla was the one people said was the standout of the Seven Sanctum. She was the special one. Everybody complimented Nyla, but everybody berated Ayla. Because let me tell you, what did people do when Nyla faced challenges like Erica, like Christina May, like Devin Lynn, Katie Bell? What did people do? They praised Nyla. But when Ayla took on challenges like Ava and Alpha, what did they do to Ayla? They berated her and called her an idiot. So, again, while I don't agree with what Ayla's doing, I also cannot blame Ayla at the same exact time. I think there were better ways to solve it, but then again, the human mind can do a crazy thing when pushed far enough. And as a quote from Butch, for example, the sanest man can be reduced to lunacy in just one day. And I believe that was partly the case with Ayla here. Forearm sliding into the corner as Nancy Crable was taken out. Good hook to Tomiko. Ayla right on top of Nancy Crable, and of course the Crable. It is tradition. Of course they're going to try to get involved. This may allow Nancy Crable to climb back on top. Grabbing Ayla. Whoa, Northern Lights suplex! Cover and a kick out immediately. Ayla giving no life to the Crable. Rolling elbow! Nancy Crable goes down. Nancy, who rolled to the outside of the ring. Ayla, of course, with the Crable sisters in her sight. Off the rope. Nancy's in trouble. Ayla! Scaring Nancy Crable a little bit. Teasing her, showing her that at any point she can, oh, try to get rid of her, but that may have gave Nancy Crable an opening. She counters, but so does Ayla back the other way. Double kick right across the dome. Crable trying to crawl back to her feet, but I don't know how much longer you can really go. And maybe this time, Ayla will not mess around. Nancy Crable in trouble for real this time. Here comes Ayla. Tope con Hilo diving right on top of Nancy Crable. Ayla so far so good in this match. Watch out. Brenda Crable, of course, trying to get involved, allowing Nancy Crable to climb back into this thing. Oh, God! Angels cry out of absolutely nowhere. You might as well just, she might as well be dead. I honestly, she might be out for the entirety of the rest of this match. I would not be surprised. Ayla kicking off on Nancy Crable over and over and over again. Crable has nowhere to go from the lethal strike of Ayla. Off the rope. Angels cry again! Oh my God! Right across the ropes as well. An innovative move that might allow Ayla to take the victory completely out of nowhere. Once again, and another angel cry! Good Lord, men! Ayla just absolutely decimating Nancy Quabo at every sense of the way on the top rope. And it's a try again! Oh, God, man! Nancy Quabo, absolutely nowhere to go. Piercing elbow in the corner. Ayla now on the springboard. Heaven gate! Say goodnight to Nancy Quabo. Ayla looking more dangerous than ever before with a newfound motivation, a newfound reason for everything she's doing. And it seems to be paying off in terms of her skills. A great win over Nancy Quabo and quite a few great new moves that I have not seen Ayla pull out before. We've seen the Heaven's Gate, but not in that way. We've seen the angels cry, but not in all the innovative ways that Ayla has been bringing out tonight. But what an interesting victory as Ayla looks to climb towards the Heritage Championship at the Royal Rumble with a win under her belt. Did she call Ayla so hot? That's not the takeaway. So Ayla wants to take a pit stop on the road to the Royal Rumble for the tag team match against Nyla. And apparently she has a partner. I'm interested. I mean, I want to see what that's all about. But then again, I mean, it's kind of true. But Cena made busy, so who the hell does Nyla have to come to her aid? I mean, I'm sure there's a lot of people who would like to help Nyla. She's a great person. But, I mean, I don't know. But that's for next week. And ladies and gentlemen, Rafael Draco returns tonight on Chaos. The Chaos Champion. He's had some interesting interactions over the last couple of weeks with various different opponents. His last match was against Justice and War Games, where Von Jacobs pinned Rafael Draco. And even just last week, after Von Jacobs made that match, he made it very clear that his next step in his career is a world championship. And there are only three world championships in this company: Akuma and the Velocity Championship, Eli Frost and the Universal Championship, and Rafael Draco with the Chaos Championship. And since Paul is with Eli and Akuma's on Velocity, it only needs one man, and it happens to be the man that Von Jacobs pinned in War Games. Could we be looking at a potential Von Jacobs versus Rafael Draco matchup? Thank you. is in question. A dream match. One that we might have never thought we would get after the events that happened at the end of last year. But tonight, they stand face to face for the first proper time. But Daniel Garcia still nowhere to be found after the result of what happened at SummerSlam. I truly do hope Garcia is okay and we see her soon, but take all the time she needs, understandably, because of Gracie Lewis. But continuing on tonight, another big event to come out of SummerSlam. It involves the Ascension. Damien, here tonight on Chaos. All alone. Which is not a familiar sight for anybody watching right now. Damien has been in the tag team with Kane for a long, long time, ever since they founded the Ascension at the beginning of last year. Of course, Angelica Lopez joined near the halfway point of last year. Damien's girlfriend, of course, and Kane's girlfriend, Erica, who was down in Havoc, got called up to the main roster earlier this year and has caused a big rift in the Ascension, leading to Kane turning on Damien and Erica becoming the new leader of the Ascension. Damien, of course, still rocking the gear, though. There's no way he's going to let this go that easily, especially because of Kane. The Ascension is his home. It's where everything they've done has been. I mean, they were tag team champions together, and Kane threw it all away because of Erica. Wait, I thought Erica might have held him back, but not tonight. Kane gonna step right up to Damien, two former tag team champions. How? Well, Erica continues to pull the strings, but Royal Rumble could be a turning point. Why are they back? Not again. What the fuck? We just got done with them earlier in the show. Well, ladies and gentlemen, here they come again. Oh, wait, no, it's actually just Duke Quavo. That's still not good. That's not better, but well. Well, earlier tonight, we saw Nancy Quable fall to Ayla. Now, Duna is going to get her ass kicked by Christina May, apparently. Wait, why is she? She's taking Christina May? What the fuck? She's going to die. Well, I'm not going to say I feel bad. I don't feel bad. But, like, damn. Well, talk of a win for Christina May. Regardless of the fact, not going to say I don't want to be disrespectful because it is the Quavo, but, well, Christina May, who ironically has been dealing with Erica, who we just saw get done with June and Nancy to some extent. We saw the interaction beforehand a couple of weeks back, and we even saw it last week on Chaos. So it really makes you wonder what Erica's goal is, because not only did Erica have the Ascension to fight, now challenging them to a match at the Royal Rumble, Erica also vowed that she will win the Royal Rumble. So Erica seems to be on double duty at the Royal Rumble. And I wonder how that's going to fare for her. I can only imagine. Without any further ado, the national champion, Mama Christina May, the Twisted Grip has arrived tonight to whoop a Cradle ass. One of the things I've wondered, ever since Erica has been getting involved with Christina May, is what is Erica's plan? Because you're like, surely she has to have some sort of plan. Erica, who's dealing with the Ascension, is she going to try to do two feuds at once? Or is there something bigger at play here? Erica has a lot on her plate, and Christina May has brought that up. She made it clear that Erica, not that she can't handle it, but will she be able to handle it with all the pressure, all the stress, all the ongoing matches and feuds and moments? I mean, she's on double duty at the Rumble. So it really makes you question what's going to happen with Erica here. Well, most of what's going to happen with Christina May. Not that I'm worried for her safety, because we are talking Christina May here. She can defend herself, but I guess it's more of the security of her championship. Should be more worried about the security of June Quable. I think she just got a concussion from the first move of the match. Well, Christina May, who looks to take a pretty easy, no disrespect, no shade, no, I'm kidding, there's a lot of shade in that, a pretty easy victory over June Quable. Oh my God, well, I mean, this is just a warm-up. This is a training session for Christina May. That's basically exactly what this is. We're witnessing murder on live TV. Three kicks in the corner. Two Quavo might be out like a light. Drop kick into the corner as well. Finish it off. Christina May looking to make quick work of June Quavo here. Climb to the very top. Once Quavo back on her feet. On the top rope. Drop kick thrown away. Quavo actually tried to fight back, but she runs to the outside of the ring. Try for some security! Sliding into a drop kick and May wipes it off June Quable! He said, where the hell do you think you're going? You're not running away from me. You silly goose. You goofball. You goofy goober. You idiot. You dumbo. You dumbhead. You pinhead. You bobblehead. You're still able to drop kick off the straight board. In control. As expected, May in the corner, June Quable in a little bit of trouble. Uh-oh, this is, wait, I think, oh no, yeah. No! Right on the hard head of June Quable. I don't think her big ass forehead can protect her from a super kick though. It's a big target to hit, but June Quable will counter somehow. What the fuck? Tries for the quick kick. Christina May trying to break out of this one. Not a lot of getting. Looks for a stunner. Counter. June Quable. Oh no! Blue Thunder! Tries for the top kick. What? Stunner! Well, thank the Lord for that one. June Quable out like a light. And ladies and gentlemen, I think it is time. One of the most beautiful moves in the company. Super kick, and here we go! Scaling to the very top rope!
Dina May! Clifton End! Covered by the national champion! And it's just another day in the business!
The Quables are just, they're literally just dog food. Like, they are just, they're literally just dished out and bowled from people that just eat. Like, they don't serve any purpose but to be demolished. Well, I don't know if I want to see a Quable resurgent, but I will say it is quite sad to see their downfall from how they were before. But I guess everybody else has leveled up. And one of those people is Christina May. Win by May tonight on Chaos, the national champion of... Oh, wait, what? Huh? Whoa! What? Who that? Who the hell is that? Wow, whoa! Who the hell is that? Whoa, what? I'm sorry? Who is that? Metronoco Driver! Excuse me? I don't understand. What the hell was that just about? Who was that? I have next to no fucking clue what that was about. And I'm kind of scared to know. But, okay, sure. I'll just disregard that for next week or whatever. Okay. Well, as we continue on the night, following the results of last week on Chaos, this is going to be an interesting matchup. A tag team match we've gotten, well, that's even the first time both of these people are tagging with each other. Hero Mullet, Ryan Nikoju versus Warhawk and Isaiah Draco tonight.
The following contest is a tag team match set for one fall. Introducing first, from Richmond, Virginia, weighing in at 247 pounds, Hero Mullet.
It's a bit of an oddball pairing, but I guess after what happened last week, it kind of makes sense. But, well, ladies and gentlemen, it is time to ask the age-old question, the biggest cliche in wrestling history. Can they coexist? Bet you never heard that one before. But it rarely ever happens in PCW. So give them some slack here, okay? Regardless though, this is a big test for the both of them heading into the Royal Rumble. Warhawk teaming with his cousin Isaiah Draco, the Heritage Champion. We know he's got to defend at the Royal Rumble, and it's going to be an interesting, I guess, test for Warhawk in his first ever championship title defense. But here comes the Akihiro! Ryan Nikoju has arrived!
And his partner from Tokyo, Japan, weighing in at 228 pounds, Ryan Yamamoto.
Now, why don't we talk about the results of last week? It was a fatal four-way match to contend for the Heritage Championship at the Royal Rumble. And Ryan Nikoju and Hero Mullen pinned Jack Maverick and Benjamin Murray at the same exact time. So they both picked up the win, and there could have been two things that happened. A one-on-one match with them and a number one contender, or a triple threat. And apparently, mutually or not, they decided on a triple threat. But of course, that was after attacking Warhawk with a double super kick. And then Hero Mullen hitting a mark of pride on Nikoju and running out, claiming that he won. But it is a triple threat, so he did not win. But it does make me wonder if they're going to be able to coexist tonight because of that reasoning. Sure, the Nikoju can't be too happy about it, and he shouldn't be. But I am still curious if they can put those differences aside just for tonight, heading into the Royal Rumble. But of course, here comes the Heritage Champion, Warhawk and Isaiah, teaming for the first time. You might have thought they were a team before, but not quite yet.
Combined weight of 499 pounds.
Wow. 499 pounds supposed to make up. Isaiah Draco, a lot of accolades under his belt, but none of them recent. Back in year one and year two, a Royal Rumble winner, WrestleMania main eventer, two-time Chaos champion, two-time tag team champions. Isaiah Draco, ironically one of the most decorated competitors in the company. But all of that was done in the first 2 years. In year three and so far this year, Isaiah Draco has zero accolades to add to his list. He had a great match against Diego Rocha at SummerSlam for the Global Championship, but of course he was not successful. But of course, he has been looking better than usual. He seems to be on the rise, at the very least, which is good. He's starting to, I guess, kind of find his footing in the Empire, trying to gain his own, I mean, I guess his own identity in some way, even though anybody in the Empire is pretty much, you know, stripped of their identity. But that's kind of due to Raphael. I don't know, but starting off this match, Hiro Mullins, Isaiah Draco, they were tag team champions together, and Isaiah Draco looked out of it. Tagged in Warhawk. He says, I'm not fighting this guy. And Warhawk doesn't want to be tagged in. He's pissed off about it. Hiro Mullins tagged in Yokozu and Warhawk tagged out. He wants nothing to do with Yokozu. And Isaiah Draco doesn't want to see that. He tagged Warhawk back in. They can't decide who's going to go in. Oh! And there's Yokozu! Right across the head. Oh no, Isaiah cheap shot from behind. And Warhawk allowed to get on top. Well, that's a way to start the match. Warhawk stomping out the former TakeOver champion, Royal Rumble winner. Yokozu in his own right had a couple of accolades under his belt, a couple of match of the year candidates on top of it, and he himself is right near the top 10 of the greatest of all time. Sometimes you don't have to have all the accolades in the world, and a good example of that is Don Jacobs. He's only held one championship in his career. That's really his only accolade. Yet, it is such a big accolade that has gotten him in the top 10 of the greatest of all time list. It's not about how many accolades you have, it's about how great those accolades were. Unless you're Ian Young, apparently. Off the rope, try for a cannonball and connect it. Yokozu down and out. Warhawk grabbing the head of Yokozu. Whoa! What a counter! Ryan Yokozu at a left heel! Tried to that knee, went nowhere. It's Warhawk all of a sudden, it's right back on top, even after that beautiful fit and fitting heel kick off of a roundhouse attempt, or a toe kick attempt by Warhawk, and a tag to Hiro Mullins. Tried for the knee. Warhawk didn't see it coming, but he was able to act accordingly. Big clothesline. Hiro Mullins gets destroyed. Warhawk pacing around Mullen, double team in the corner, and he tags in Isaiah Draco. Off the rope, both of them land a shoulder block on Hiro Mullins, and Isaiah Draco, not a legal man, on top. Not paying attention, no! Neckbreaker from behind! Should not attend to the crowd. Rolling elbow, no. No hail, super kick move. Oh! But Isaiah Draco, all of a sudden, right back on top. A big single kick to the side of the head, trying for a arrow war. Hiro Mullins goes back to Soda. Isaiah Draco, who tries for a chop off, but it doesn't go his way. Neckbreaker attempt, rolling elbow caught. Back and forth between the two. Nobody can seem to get the upper hand. Super kick avoided. Draco runs in for a rolling elbow. Once again, a counter. Mullins trying to stave off anything. Draco catches the leg, hooks him up, powerbomb! And Draco, throughout all of that, is the one to stand tall. Hiro Mullins trying to crawl for a tag to Ryan Yokozu. Draco says no way. Oh! Hiro Mullins able to kick him off though. Caught! Spine Buster! By Isaiah Draco, the artist of war! The one in control for the Empire of the Elite. The General of the Empire, as they call themselves here, this little tag team. Off the rope, Tome Con Hilo! Great athleticism from Isaiah Draco. It has not dissipated since year one, ladies and gentlemen. The opportunity still lies deep within, but it's certainly not easy to bring it out when you're going against these guys. But an arrow of war on the outside of the ring. Watch it, Yokozu out of nowhere. Diving right on top of Isaiah Draco. Warhawk sees this though. He's not happy about it. Clothesline from behind. Wipes out Ryan Yokozu, and this is where Isaiah Draco throwing him, but Yokozuna stops himself, taking out Draco, throwing him right into Hiro Mullins, who slams him right into the corner of the announce table. Teamwork, unexpectedly, from Mullins and Yokozuna. But you gotta do what you gotta do. There is a bigger picture here than just each other, and it is Warhawk and the Heritage Championship. You gotta beat him. It's almost mandatory, it's a necessity. Going into the Royal Rumble, tries for a Markham Pride. Isaiah Draco, great counter out of hard play up the rope. Oh my! What a shoulder block! Turning Hiro Mullins inside out. A quick tag to Warhawk, not a legal man. Mullins trying to call for the tag, nowhere to go, and Warhawk will slam him right onto the ground, face first. Warhawk right in the face of Ryan Yokozuna. Big knee across the head as well. Oh my God! Damn! Well, that's why you don't taunt Yokozuna. He just fucking killed him. That might have hit the Warhawk off though. Oh God! Down goes the Akihiro. Hiro Mullins is all alone in the ring with Warhawk. From behind. Gallagher! No! Mullins breaking out with the back elbow to the back of the head. Mullins trying to lift up. Get out of it to Warhawk, see the line. Oh, watch it for your grave. Warhawk destructive on Hiro Mullins. And could be looking to give the Generals of the Empire a big win tonight on Chaos. Hawkeye! Watch it though. That's not the end of the story. I don't know where it's going to go. Warhawk will stab him up. Watch it! Gallagher the attempt, but Yokozuna a quick counter. Right hand to the spine. Yokozuna said, you are not going anywhere. Setting sign! And allowed! Hiro Mullins to climb back on top. Trying for the throw back, but somehow Warhawk is able to counter. Trying for the Gallagher. He countered too. Hiro Mullins, throw back! Watch out, the Draco with the Final destination! Kinshasa! Everybody! Wiping out everybody! Holy hell! But watch it. Back up. Try for the Gallagher. Back and forth! Everybody struggling! But Isaiah Draco allowing Warhawk to capitalize with a quick little shot at Hiro Mullins before he escapes the ring. And a tag to Draco. My God, man. Draco trying his best. Mullins. And Alvaro to try and knock him away. Markham Pride. And a tag to the Akihiro. And this could be troublesome. For Isaiah Draco. Gouted by Ryan Yokozuna. For a throwaway. Pulls the leg off the Kinshasa. Final destination! Hiro Mullins in from behind. Draco counters. Scissor kick counted as well. Mullins said, turn your ass back around. Throw back! Mullins giving the upper hand despite it all. Closing in on a victory. Wiping out Warhawk, heel kick in the corner. Ryan Yokozuna, here we go! Gouting him up, diving him down. Kinshasa! Out of the corner, he wipes out Warhawk. Back to his seat, one last time! Kinshasa! Huge win heading into the Royal Rumble, and Warhawk got to be pissed off about that one. Isaiah Draco taking the pin tonight. But again, you are going against Ryan Yokozuna. That is an incredibly tough man to fight.
Here are your winners.
So they were able to close this after all. I have to say I'm surprised. Sure, he gets a get back. That's what it is. Well, watch out!
follow-up of Gjallarhorn to your poser, and what a moment as well! Cleaning up the mess, heading into the Royal Rumble. Got a pain, Vaughn Jacob, to some extent to hear that. Here she is. We knew she was coming, and she is here. What? Oh no! Oh no! What the hell? What are you doing? Oh no! I remember from last week. Deontay Carter, what the hell are you doing?
Shit! Tracy Lewis! big mistake might have just been made. Chief Hope, the Night Owl. And the Night Owl almost stabbed right back.